Galleon's wrath upon Nevendar was a thing of nightmares. He had lashed out at his lost lover, Mortis, with unmatched ferocity. His rage had manifested itself as a great beast, an unthinking behemoth that slaughtered indiscriminately. Galleon's corrupted son, Lachlan, perished along with a great number of Mortis's corpse army, dwarves, and even elves. Horrified at what he had become, even for a brief moment, Galleon abandoned his children. Elven society soon changed. The elven nobles continued to grow in power, and Illumiel succeeded into her position as queen. The noble elves shared a common taste with the humans. They built elaborate cities, donned gleaming armor, and studied the methods of organized warfare. However, deep in the forest, the savage elves began to protest these civilized methods. They embraced their heritage as wilderness creatures. They shied away from other races, preferring isolation to possible betrayal. This wild bunch of elves, under the unofficial leadership of Torok, created a sense of dread within the once serene forests. Any who strayed too deep into the wilderness became a potential victim for the elven bandits. Scouts had begun to observe Mortis's fiends pushing further into the elven lands.
Thank you. Elemeneal. Elemeneal.
Where? We move.
Lacuna.
Thank you. If I must.
Liaga? With pleasure. I trust in you. Where? We move.
Tetero!
me? With pleasure.
castle.
I trusted you. We move.
This over with.
Thank you.
Lassel.
We move.
Let's get this over with.
Where? We move.
I am here. Let's get this over.
move.
Thuna! Thuna!
Thank you. Thank you.